Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? Yesterday I think we were discussing about the scheme number 18. The heading of that is a total synthesis of originally assigned structure of Venus cell B, which is to the description of this scheme number 18 we have fully described with there and how the different structure uses of different structures and how the proper conditions are maintained and how much amount of the percentage of yields are obtained, that we were discussed in our previous lecture. Today what we are going to discuss, the whatever the reagent and condition utilized during the synthesis, that we are discussing over here. Now is the reagents and conditions, reagents and conditions that we are discussing about. So first reagent which they have used, a reagent, that is a POCl3, that is chloride, that which was taken near about 6.0 equivalent, then pyridine, and the temperature is kept around 60 degrees centigrade, and then that reaction mixture was stirred about 3 hours and percentage of yield is obtained near about 81%, very high yield. Now the second reagent which was used during the synthesis was CS2, carbon disulfide, which was taken around 8.0 equivalent, followed by NaH sodium hydroxide, which was taken around 6.0 equivalent, then solvent employed THF tetrahydrofuran, and the temperature is kept around 0 to 25 degree centigrade, and that reaction mixture was stirred about 30 minutes, and then slowly added methyl iodide in it, which was taken around 12.0 equivalent, and once more the temperature is kept 0 to 25 degree centigrade, and that reaction mixture was stirred about 3 hours, and then after the temperature is kept around 185 degree centigrade of microwave irradiation in 1,2-dichlorobenzene, and the reaction mixture was stirred about 15 minutes, and the percentage of yield is obtained about 92%, and then C reagent which were used as Thex BH2, THEX, Thex BH2, which was taken around 5.0 equivalent, THF tetrahydrofuran, the temperature is kept around minus 10 to 25 degree centigrade, the reaction mixture was stirred about 30 minutes and then 30%, then 30% H2O2, 30% H2O2 and the three normal aqueous HCl hydrochloric acid, three normal aqueous sodium hydroxide, not the HCl, NaOH sodium hydroxide, which was taken 1:1 and the temperature is kept around 25 to 40 degree centigrade and that reaction mixture was stirred about 1 hour and the percentage of yield is obtained 65%, which was overall yield is approximately 1:1.3 diastereomers. Then the next reagent which was used during the synthesis is as follows. Let us see that reagent also, D reagent will be this one, ortho nitro C6H4 ACCN selenium cyanide, which was taken around 2.0 equivalent. Then NBu3P, then 6.0 equivalent, 6.0 equivalent pyridine, which was taken around 12.0 equivalent. Then the solvent is used as a THF tetrahydrofuran at 25 degree centigrade temperature is kept. That reaction mixture was stirred near about 10 minutes and then 10 minutes then 30% H2O2, 30% H2O2 were used and that temperature is kept around 0 to 25 degree centigrade and which was stirred near about 12 hour and the percentage of yield is obtained 67%. And next reagent is a E reagent was used as Ac2 acetyl anhydride, which was taken around 20.0 equivalent. Then triethylamine followed, which was also taken as a 20.0 equivalent, and then 4-DMAP, which is 4-dimethylaminopyridine, which was the full form of that 4-DMAP, which was taken around 1.0 equivalent. Then CH2Cl2, that is a dichloromethane, CH2, Cl2, dichloro, methane. The reaction mixture was stirred about 24 hours and overall yield is obtained 96%. And after that, let us see the next reagent which were used here, F reagent. F reagent is a KHMDS, that is a potassium hexamethyl diazide silyl, which was taken at 0.5 mole in toluene 5.0 equivalent, then TSCl, which was taken around 5.0 equivalent, followed by this one, E T thrice N, which was taken approximately 8.0 equivalent, then solvent is used, THF tetrahydrofuran, followed by the temperature is kept around -78 to 25 degrees centigrade, and that reaction mixture were stirred about 30 minutes, and the overall yield is obtained about 94%. And the next reagent which we are going to discuss, F, after F there is alphabetical is a Z, that is a LIDBB, which was taken around excess amount means whatever the substrates are there. Suppose 1 gram substrate has taken, excess amount means more than 1 gram, so that is the meaning of excess. So THF tetrahydrofuran, which was taken here as an solvent, and the temperature is kept around 78 to 50 degrees centigrade, I think minus 50 degrees centigrade, and that reaction were stirred for 30 minutes and they were obtained 84% overall yield. And then next reagent will be the H reagent, and that H reagent is this one, PHIOAC twice, which was taken around 3.0 equivalent, TEMPO, and it is around 1.0 equivalent, and after that there is a this one CH2Cl2 dichloromethane, which was 25 degree centigrade, and that reaction mixture was stirred about 24 hours, and the overall percentage of yield will be obtained around 88%. And after that H, there will be a I reagent. I reagent is nothing but as acetic anhydride, ACTO, which was taken around 30 equivalent and then 30 equivalent, then 4 DM AP dimethyl, 4 NN dimethyl aminopyridine, which was taken around 1.0 equivalent, and the solvent used employed CH2, Cl2 dichloromethane. Temperature is kept around 25 degree centigrade, and that reaction mixture was stirred around 12 hours. Quantity. Then J, the J reagents are as HF, pyridine, and THF tetrahydrofuran, which was taken around 1:4 proportion, and the temperature is kept around 25 degree centigrade, and this reaction was stirred about 3 hours. Then 3 normal aqueous HCl / THF tetrahydrofuran, which was 1:3, and the temperature is kept around 25 degree centigrade, and that reaction mixture was stored around 6 hours, and the overall percentage obtained 80%. This is all about the reagent which were used during the. So now the next point which we are going to discuss is the figure number 3, which will give you the idea about how NOA play an important role in determining. Figure number 3, here figure 3, 2 we already seen previously, NOE is observed for compound, for compound plus 98, and which I am going to represented over here. The structure 95 will be like this. This is a structure which I am showing over here. 5 member ring connected each other, followed by a 6 member ring. There is a further attachment of this ring, then 5 member ring which were joined over here. This is a isopropylene group O. This is a protected. Now this is the group which is above the plane O, same, and there is a OAC group over here, OAC acetyl group. Here is a carbon-carbon double bond. Here the group which is a protected hydroxyl group with bond, the A ring which contain isopropylene group along with O protecting secondary alcohol with bond. Here is a hydrogen atom which is above the plane. Here the hydrogen atom which is below the plane. Now here the hydrogen atom which is not at 10 number, the hydrogen atom which is below the plane. Now, what this is a 10 number, and here there will be a NOE observed between this as well as the NOE is observed between this proton H7 and the H7. This one is a 7 as we know that. Now, the what we can say over here NOE is between. NOE is between H10 H7 and H10 H27 and H10 H27, where NOE is nothing but it is one of the technique which is useful for the structure determination. When the two protons are very close proximity, and due to that the NOE is observed, the intensity of that peak is observed, or that is a subtracted spectra. Once you take as a spectra, you will get the signals due to the hydrogen atoms, and after irradiation, whatever the proton, if you suppose here is a proton number H is irradiated, that will absorb or that will give the negative signal, and there is a enhancement in a signal with that close proximity 27. So, that is the concept of NOE, which plays the important role or big role in determining the structure of the organic compound. So, positive NOE signal observed. Here is a positive positive NOE signal observed. Positive NOE signal observed here. And now, and that is in the enhancement, right? Now, in the next figure, this is a structure number plus 95. Now, I am showing another structure. Here you can see one more another structure. This is a structure I am showing over here. 5-membered ring which is connected over here, another 5-membered ring, this would be connected over here. Here isopropylene group O connected like this, other thing remains as it is. Here O, AC, M, here double bond. Now, the hydrogen atom here hydroxyl group should be above the plane. Ultimately, this hydrogen atom is below the plane. This is a 28 carbon atom over here. Now, the hydrogen atom which is present at this corner is below the plane. Now, look at this is a ring where the isopropylene group below the plane. Here, this is protected with that bomb. This is a hydrogen atom which is above the plane. Here, the hydrogen atom which is below the plane, and now this structure is nothing but, now not this one, this is a hydrogen atom which should be above the plane. Now, here the group which is here, this should be above the plane. Now, O bomb, BOM bomb protected. This is a 27 and this 27. So, there is a what we can call it as a no NOE is observed between this as well as there is a no NOE. So this is a structure of plus 98. This is a structure of plus 98, and what could you see? No NOE. No NOE between H10 and H7. H10 and H7, because they are not in the close proximity, they are with transposition, and therefore NOE is not observed over there. No NOE signal observed. Therefore, no NOE signal observed. So that is the conclusion we can draw from these two. So having reached an intermediate plus 94 with all stereo centers in their proper configuration, only a short path separated us from the targeted molecule, that is the scheme number 18, which we have seen. Thus, the requisite aldehyde and the acetate functionalities of the molecule were installed through a four-step sequence involving selective functionality group manipulators. So that is a KHMDS, TESCL quantitative, LIDBB, THF minus 78 to minus 50 degree centigrade, 84% yield were obtained, PHIOAC twice, tempo 88% yield, and acetic anhydride 4DMP, 80 thricean quantitative. Finally, global deprotection through sequential treatment with HFPY and aqueous ACL in the same pot furnished the coveted vanucel B structure 2 in 80% overall yield, and it was with much disappointment and dismay, however, that they came to realize that the NMR spectroscopic data of their synthetic material, although similar, did not match those reported for natural vanucel B. And see following article for differences. So I think with this NOE effect, in the next lecture we will see the remaining part, remaining discussion of this articles. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.